generally Venn diagrams are diagrams which are represented with help of squares, circles, triangles, rectangles and whatnot. Generally we use circles to represent a particular Venn diagram. This is the world universal set, and here we have three set A, B and C. Let A represent number of students who have taken up subject A in a college, B represent number of students who have taken up subject B, and C represent number of students who is studying subject C in a particular university maybe. So this is the university. We might have few students who haven't picked up any of these courses A, B, C. This, for them, this is this part. And these parts says something related to A, B, C. So now if we look closely, we can see that we have 1, 2, 8 parts to this particular diagram. Whenever we have three set, maximum number of parts which can be formed in the set diagram, in a Venn diagram, is 8. Why? Because we have three set. So the code is, if we have suppose n set, then the maximum parts of that particular Venn diagram would be 2n. Two sets, you can see that maximum parts which can be formed with the two sets is 1, 2, 3 and 4. Why? Because 2 to the power 2 is equals to 4. So when we are dealing with circles and a square or a rectangle which form a world or universal set, this is the key question which can be asked. If we have three sets and an universal set, maximum number of parts which we can see are 8. Now, what are these parts actually indicating? First, let's look at 1. 1 is common to all. It is common to A, B and C. That's why we write this as A, B, C or A intersection B intersection C. Now these are the 8 parts which all can be represented with help of ABC format of formulas, and hence it becomes very easy for us to identify vis-a-vis the set theory notation these parts. Part A is neither to A, neither to B, neither to C. Maximum number of parts which can be formed with n number of sets are 2 to the power n, and this is how it's been broken. Now, how it's been broken also depend upon something which is combination technique or binomial coefficient. If we have three sets, you can see that breakup is 1, 3, 3, 1. That means these are nothing but 3C0, 3C1, 3C2 and 3C3. Before moving forward, let us also talk about A union B format. This is our set A and B. What if we need to find the total of this A union B? This is known as A union B. Then A union B is simply count the number of elements in set A, count the number of elements in set B, and then deduct the common area. Same goes with if we have three sets A, B and C. A union B union C would be A plus B. How the formula is devised? Now, if I want to devise this for four set, very easily we can devise this. For three set, how it is devised? First, we have taken one at a time, deduct two at a time, add three at a time. If I have 4 set, can I devise formula for A union B union C union D without actually remembering? Yes, it would be very easy for us to devise it. How to devise? We will start with taking one set at a time, I'm not writing n, and let me write the set itself. It would be a plus b plus c plus d. Then deducting, taking two at a time, minus ab, minus ac, minus ad, minus bc, minus bd, minus cd. Done. Now adding, taking three at a time, adding abc plus bcd plus cda plus dab, and after that we will deduct, taking all at a time, minus of abcd. This becomes the formula for four set. Now it is also very simple to check whether we have done it correctly or not. Let us count the number of elements we have written in the formula. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. We have 15 elements in this formula. And how to check whether this is correct or not? Number of elements in the formula should be 2 to the power 4 minus 1. That is, there should be 15 elements in this formula. Let's check it for 3. If there are 3 sets, number of elements in the formula for A union B union C should be 2 to the power 3 minus 1, that is 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. For 2 sets, number of elements in the formula should be 2 square minus 1, that is 3. We have 3. So with this technique, we can form formulas for A union B union C, union D union E, whatever it is, for any number of sets given to us. A simple example is there on your screen. Maybe like 3 or 4 elements are given to us. They can be living objects or non-living objects. And now, first set of questions they can ask, that what Venn diagram fits in if we want to represent this particular set of 3 objects with help of Venn diagram. Let's do this with an example. We have an example on the screen. We have deer, rabbit and mammals. Now, can we describe these 3 things with help of Venn diagram? Whenever we are trying to describe this help of Venn diagram, what is important is try to identify whether we have a universal or a world set given. If we take deer, it is an animal. Rabbit, it is an animal. Mammal is a kind of, that means animal ko agar main hata dun, I can call both deer and rabbit a mammal. Now deer and rabbit both are mammals, isn't it? But deer and rabbit are no friends. They are not same type of mammals. That means the circle for the Venn diagram for deer and mammal should be different. Let's see what we can build out of this example. This is deer and rabbit. Okay, so we have a deer and rabbit, and the third one should be mammal, enclosing deer and rabbit. So these kind of questions are very radially asked. 3 or 4 objects would be given, and we need to identify in which particular Venn diagram they fit in. But for practicing purpose, I haven't given it options. Let's try out and figure out that what different kind of Venn diagrams we can form. Let's take one more example. Human beings, teachers, graduates. Clearly, human being must be the universal set, and we will have teachers and graduates. Few teachers are graduates and few graduates may be teachers, but both teachers and graduates are human beings and graduates. Few graduates may be teachers and few teachers are graduates. That's why we have a common set among teachers and graduates, and both are human beings. The universal set should be human beings. Here, in universal set human being, teacher and graduate may have a common portion. Whales, fishes and crocodiles. How we can arrange them as far as character is concerned? If I look all three belongs to water bodies. But water is not given to me. So I don't need an universal set for this. It is very clear. Now whales, if I can recall, whales are mammals. Fishes belong to pieces. And crocodiles are reptiles. Means all three are water bodies. But whales are mammals, fishes belong to pieces class, and crocodiles belong to reptile class. And since whale is not given to us, I can form a Venn diagram where all the circles are apart. Yes. We can form something like this. These are my whales, which are different from fishes, and whales and fishes are different from crocodiles. Plums, potatoes, and fruits. Pause the video and give it a try. Plums belongs to fruits, but potatoes doesn't belong to fruits. So I can have a group of fruits. Okay, I have a group of fruits and plums are all to the group of fruits. That means plums should be subset of fruit. These subset of fruit, the proper subset of fruit, all plums are fruit, but potatoes are no fruit. Potatoes are no fruit. That should be outside the purview of potatoes, I guess. Yes, it should be outside the review of fruit. Rings, ornaments, and diamond rings. What we can form out of this. But this time, to help you out, I think I should give you options. Try to identify option A, B, C, or D. Which option fits in for rings, ornaments, and diamond rings? And you know the drill. Pause the video and try to identify it. Then check out for the answer. Eliminate kar sakte hain? Kya C ho sakta hai? Kya ornament rings and diamond rings se common area aa sakta hai? Common area bolega ki main ornament hoon, main ring hoon. So bhai, सारे रिंग्स तो ऑर्नामेंट के अंदर ही आते हैं. ऑल रिंग्स आर पार्ट ऑफ ऑर्नामेंट. डायमंड रिंग, ये तो और क्लियरिटी है कि ऑल डायमंड रिंग्स शुड गो अप टू रिंग्स ओनली, इजंट इट? ऑल डायमंड रिंग्स शुड गो अप टू रिंग्स ओनली, मतलब डायमंड रिंग्स शुड बी सबसेट ऑफ रिंग्स. कहीं पर है पूरा प्रॉपर सबसेट? डी में प्रॉपर सबसेट नहीं दिख रहा है, सी में प्रॉपर सबसेट नहीं दिख रहा है कोई, बी में कोई भी प्रॉपर सबसेट नहीं है, लेकिन ऑप्शन ए में वी हैव प्रॉपर सबसेट. दिस इज प्रॉपर सबसेट. दिस वुड बी डायमंड रिंग्स व्हिच इज इनसाइड द सर्कल और वेन डायग्राम फॉर रिंग्स. नाउ बोथ कैन बी पार्ट ऑफ ऑर्नामेंट. द बेस्ट ऑप्शन दैट फिट्स इन इज ए. कंप्यूटर स्किल्ड, ग्रेजुएट्स एंड एम्प्लॉयड. Let's see the options. A, B, C, D. Which option fits in? Teen aadmi hai mere paas. Kya ye aadmi ke paas teeno cheeze nahi ho sakti hain? Ye hai Mr. A. Can Mr. A be computer skilled? Yes. Is he graduate? Yes. Is he employed? Yes. मतलब एक इंसान में ये तीनों खूबी पाई जा सकती हैं. That means what? These three can all have a common space. And that common space is only there in option C. You can meet a person in your life who is computer skilled, even a graduate, and also employed. You can have a common space. Option C fits in outrightly. a diagram with circle, rectangle, triangle, square, everything is given, and all parts are marked. First question. Educated male who is not an urban resident, pick up the number which you think fits in. Four options are there on your screen. Which out of 4, 5, 9 or 11 represents the educated male who is not an urban resident? Educated male, yes. Educated male, rectangles. Urban resident is circle. I need to find portion of rectangle which is not covered or occupied by C. So we have male, which is rectangle, urban resident, which is circle, and educated also, which is triangle. I need T plus R minus C. Just look out for T and R. This is T and R, but minus C is 11. Question 2, option there. Neither a civil servant, minus S, nor educated, but is urban, means plus C, and not a male, minus R. I need C minus S minus R. C mein se S R hata do. That means I am only look out for only C. Which portion represents only C? Part number 3. Female, urban resident, and also a civil servant. There is no figure representing female. That means for female, I can call it minus R. Urban resident is plus C. Also, civil servant is plus S. I am looking for S plus C minus R. S mein hai 7, 10, 6, 13. Plus C kar dunga main. So 10 and 6 basta hai. Ab isme se R wala portion ko minus karna hai. We are left with only 10. Option 10 fits in. Educated plus T. Male plus R. Who hails from urban area plus C. I'm just looking out for T plus R plus C. In T, I have 4, 11, 5. Now, the common portion with R is 4 and 11. Common portion with circle is 4. So, best fitted answer is 4. Dot should be there in point number 4. 4 means an educated male who hails from an urban area. Uneducated means we are looking for minus T. Urban is C. Male is R. This is C plus R minus T. Let's start with C. C mein hai mere paas 3, 12, 10, 6, 4. Plus R. C that is in R is only 12, 6, 4. 12, 6, 12, 6 and 4. Minus T. T mein nahi hone chahiye. T mein 4 aur 11 hai. T mein 4 hai. Hata denge. 6, 6 to square mein hai, 6 ko lena hi nahi hai, it is only 12, C plus R, option left is 12, this is in C plus R, but not in T. Only a civil servant, but not a male, nor urban oriented. We are looking for S minus T minus R minus C. Only S which is given in the beginning. Only a civil servant and nothing else. That is in part number 7. Answer is part number 7. Male R. Urban oriented C. Also a civil servant S but not educated minus T. R plus C plus S minus T. visible. Male civil servant R plus S, who is neither educated minus E, neither belong to urban area minus C. We are looking for R plus S minus T minus C. 13. Correct option is 13. So on that note, I'll sign off from MJ's Maths and Set, but I'll give you more questions to practice, more exercises. Just stay connected. Take up all the small tests which we are up to. That will help you out. I'll see you soon.